We just kind of set it up from Luke chapter 11 and verse number 1 that Jesus' disciples, they came to him and they saw him praying. And when he got finished praying, they said, teach us to pray like John taught his disciples to pray. And Jesus, operating in the Christ consciousness and no ego at all, said, when you pray, this is what you say. And so we're in Luke chapter 11 and verse number 2 today. And Jesus said, and these are the words to say. And Jesus began teaching them how to pray, whether you're looking from the King James or the NIV, and he started with our Father. And so we're just going to deal with those two words today that Jesus taught his disciples in the beginning of the Lord's Prayer, our Father. So let's just start with that today. Let's just start with our Father. Can you say those two words for me? Our Father. One more time. Our Father. Type those two words in. They're very powerful words. Our Father. And notice what happens when you begin a prayer with those words, our Father. That's what we're going to break down, because we got the setup, we got the background, and so now we're beginning to pray in the Christ consciousness. We're beginning to pray in the understanding and the awareness that Jesus prayed and taught his disciples to pray. Notice that when Jesus prayed, often, very often, he referred to God as Father. When he was on the cross, he began his prayer with Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. He began his cross experience with Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. He ended his cross experience by saying to them, Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit. So whatever experience that you are having, you can always cross out error thinking. You can always cross out negative beliefs. You can also cross out erroneous ideas by beginning and ending the situation with our Father. Using and referring to God as Father is the way to cross out limiting beliefs, error thoughts, erroneous ideas, and faulty perceptions. When you deal with our Father, when you say Father, represents the divine mind. And within the divine mind, there are divine ideas. So when you start with Father, you are setting yourself up to align yourself with divine mind, to align yourself with all the ideas that are in divine mind. So you're getting your mind set. And with an intentionality, you're getting your mind set with a purpose when you began with our Father. It's like writing a letter, an address to whom you are speaking. Dear John, you're saying our Father. So you're starting with the address. You're starting with the person to whom you are speaking. And so Jesus, his prayers were our Father, or Father, he would begin praying. Even when he raised Lazarus from the dead, he started the prayer with Father. Which speaks to a relationship with God. He said, Father, I know that you always hear me, but for the sake of the people around, he says, I'm praying today. And he says, and then he called Lazarus from the dead. Even when Jesus was in the Garden of Gethsemane in Matthew 26, his prayer was, Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. If there's any way that I can get out of this, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but thy will be done. And so what made Jesus' prayers so effective? What made Jesus' prayers so powerful? What made this Lord's Prayer stick around for hundreds, even thousands of years? It's how it begins. It begins with our Father. There's an intentionality that's set when you start with our Father. There is a consciousness that is established when you start with our Father. So come on, let's give me some thumbs up, give me some high fives, give me some hearts. If you are really understanding and processing how it means, because sometimes we just go through things so fast that we don't really take time to break it down. You know, we sing the same song every Sunday. We pray the same words by rote, vain repetitions, but not really consciously thinking about the words that we are saying. Do you hear the words that are coming out of my mouth? Are you thinking about what those words mean when you began with our Father? And so Jesus, he set up a standard for prayer that he used himself. Even when he was praying in John 17, he said, Father, give me the glory that I had with you before the foundation of the world. So if you look at the prayers of Jesus, you will see Father in those prayers. Very few times, very seldom does Jesus refer to the Father as God, you know, except when he was in excruciating pain. He said, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? But most of the times when Jesus prayed, he referred to God as Father. So pulley point number one, when you start with our Father, you're starting with paternity. All right. Our Father is paternity. It says, when you say our Father, you're going back to your origination point. You're going back to how you came into being. You're going back to the deepest part of you, which is God. You're going back to your genesis. You're going back to your beginning. So pulley point number one is our Father speaks of paternity. It speaks to how you got here, how you came into being, that you came into being as a result of our Father. And so when you start with that prayer, you are conscious of your origination point. You are conscious of your purpose. You're conscious that it's in God that you live and move and have your being, that you, no child gets here without his or her father. The father is a necessary part of the equation. That even naturally, before the mother carries the child, the father carries the child first. You know, in the semen is what causes the egg to be able to be fertilized. So I tell people that the father carried the child before the mother carried the child. Our Father. So you're starting with your paternity. It lets you know that I know who I am. I know that I am a child of God, that that is my identity, that I am a son, I am a daughter of God. I am made in the image and in the likeness of God. God is spirit, so therefore I am a spiritual being. When you start with our Father, it causes you to go back to your identity. It causes you to go back to your genesis, to your beginning, to your existence of how you got here. So come on, let's just say those words again. Our Father, that when I pray, I'm going past what happened, you know, what's going on right now, and I'm going to the origination point. I'm going past the negative. I'm going past whatever situation or circumstance, and I'm going back to the genesis. I'm going back to the original idea. I'm going back to God's original purpose and plan for my life. I'm praying into that idea. I'm praying into that consciousness of my origination. So pulley point number one, when you say our Father, you're talking about paternity. I didn't give you all the topic today. Our topic for today is the audacity to call God Father. That's our topic for today. The audacity. How dare you call God Father? And Jesus got into a lot of trouble for this, all right? So pulley point number one is that our Father starts off with paternity. Now, pulley point number two, when you say our Father, there's also, he didn't say my Father, but he taught them to pray our Father. So pulley point number one, in those two words, our Father, not only is there paternity, which shows you that you are originating from God, that God is your Father, but it also shows plurality. Pulley point number two is plurality, which means God is not just your Father, but God is my Father too. That God is our Father. That we're all interrelated. We're all interconnected because we have the same Father. And we have the same mother. The earth is our mother, and God is our Father. God formed human beings out of the dust of the earth. All right, so we came from a substance. We came from the earth. The earth is our mother, and God breathed into our nostrils the breath of life, and we became living souls. So that was what makes us human and divine. We get our natural part, our physical part from our mother, which is Mother Earth, and we get our divine nature from our Father. So we are both human and divine. We have both our mother and our Father, Mother Earth, and God is our Father. So we have a combination. Come on, affirm me. I am both human and divine. that I am both human and divine. And what we're learning to do is balance our humanity and our divinity. And I don't desire to be so human that I do not connect with my divine potential. And I don't desire to be so divine that I do not connect with other human beings. But our Father is a plurality, that this is a collective consciousness, that not only am I praying in the original consciousness, which is Father, but I'm also praying in a collective consciousness of our Father, that you cannot possess Father just for yourself. There's no way that God can be your Father and you not see your connection with your other brothers and sisters of the universe, regardless of age, gender, color, race, religion, orientation, socioeconomic status, family dynamic, criminal background, credit history. God is still our Father. That nothing that you have ever done in your life disqualifies God from being your Father. There's nothing that you can ever say or do or think that's going to make God disown you. God will always be your Father. Come on, affirm that with me today. God always will be my Father. Affirm it again. God will always be my Father. And if you forget who your Father is, if you're not sure about your paternity, go back to the words of the prayer of Jesus, our Father, that lets you know your paternity, that you are not a case of, well, you don't know who your Father is. You know, they got many shows on TV today where are you the Father? Are you the Father? And they do DNA testing to see who the Father is. When we test your DNA, it is clear that God is your Father just by virtue of creation. So pulley point number one, our Father lets us know our paternity. Pulley point number two, he did not say my Father because he was teaching his disciples to pray. He said, our Father, which shows them the plurality. Pulley point number two is plurality of God being all of our Father. So every woman is my sister. Every man is my brother. It is our Father. And so therefore, there's no way that you can pray our Father and operate in racism, sexism, ageism, orientationalism. There's no way that you can work in any of those isms and schisms and keep praying our Father. It separates the us and the them. It separates the me versus you. Our Father, that I am one with God. I am one with all life. I am one with the one. Come on, give me some thumbs up. Give me some high fives. Give me some hearts. If you're connecting with all your brothers and sisters of the universe and you're seeing God as our Father, that I am one with you. I'm connected with you. We've got the same mother. We've got the same Father. We're not half brothers and sisters. We're not stepsisters and brothers. We're not adopted. We have the same mother, Mother Earth. We have the same Father, which is God, our divine nature. So pulley point number one is paternity, that I know who my Father is, and I go back to my Genesis when I pray, Father. Pulley point number two, you go into plurality, which is our Father, that you don't have a monopoly on God, that you don't control God, that God is not boxed in or pigeonholed based on your image or your perspective, but God is our Father, all right? And pulley point number three, when I start with our Father, it takes me into prosperity. Pulley point number three is prosperity. So whatever it is that I'm getting ready to pray for, when I start with our Father, I pray in a prosperity consciousness. I pray in the idea of increase, abundance, overflow, and more than enough. I think about who my Father is, and therefore who I am. So pulley point number one, I'm thinking about my relationship with God. Our Father also leads us into our relationship with other people. Pulley point number three, prosperity, it leads us into what our Father has. Not only who my Father is and who I am and who we are as it relates to God being our Father, but there's no way that you can pray our Father and pray in a poverty consciousness, because my Father, our Father, is not poor. You know, what is it? If anybody asks you who I am, tell them I'm a child of God. My Father is rich. Our Father is rich and houses and land. He holds the wealth of the world in his hands, rubies and diamonds, silver and gold. Just tell him I am a child of God. So when you pray in our Father, you're praying in a prosperity consciousness. You're praying with the idea of increase, abundance, overflow, and more than enough. enough. When you pray Our Father, there is no lack. There is no limitation when you pray Our Father, because my God supplies all of our needs according to God's riches and glory in Christ Jesus. So when I pray Our Father, I'm praying in a prosperity consciousness to know that whatever I'm praying for, that God is able to do that exceeding abundantly above all that I could ask or even think, according to the power that works within me. So when I pray Our Father, I'm praying in a prosperity consciousness. I'm praying that there is no lack, there is no limitation, there's no poverty, there's no idea that the Father is not able to manifest, or I'm not able to bring into expression that which I desire, because I'm praying in the prosperity of Our Father. I'm praying in the inheritance of Our Father. I'm praying in total access to all that God is. We are heirs of God, joint heirs with Christ Jesus. So when I pray Our Father, I'm praying in a prosperity consciousness, knowing whatever I'm about to ask for, that I'm receiving it. Because Our Father, that God has it, God is it, and so therefore there's no way that there's not enough, there's no lack, there's no limitation, no poverty, no idea that it's not enough. I'm praying in a prosperity consciousness. And all you said is two words. Those two words are so powerful, Our Father. And when you think about that, when you sing that from the essence of your being, you're singing that I know who I am, paternity, I know where I come from, Our Father. That it's not just me, but I pray it collectively. I pray the highest and the best, the right and the perfect for all people of the universe, because it's a plurality, Our Father. And I pray in a prosperity consciousness that I am worthy, I deserve, I have access to all that God is. It is the Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. I don't have to beg, Our Father. I don't have to plead, Our Father. I don't have to make a bargain, Our Father. I don't have to steal or take from anybody else, Our Father. There is increase, abundance, overflow, and more than enough. And I am conscious of that when I pray, Our Father. I am enjoying this, just understanding the Lord's Prayer. And I'm going to give some shout outs to Hillary Douglas, as well to Gina Tracy. They've asked me for years to do a teaching on that, and I just hadn't felt led to do it. So I'm going to reach out to them and make sure they're getting these videos. Our Father, pulley point number one, it lets you know your paternity, your genesis, your identity. And when you don't know who your father is, you don't know who you are. There's something about your identity that is missing when you don't know who your father is. It's that knowing who your father is shapes your identity. It shapes your personhood. It shapes your character. So Our Father, pulley point number one, it's our paternity. Our Father, pulley point number two, it's plurality. Pulley point number three, Our Father also is prosperity. I love you so much. Thank you so much for being a part of the Daily Download. Share this on your page with somebody. Put it on your page. Sow a seed today. Meet a need. Boost this post. Hundreds of thousands of people need to know this truth and need to pray in this consciousness of Our Father, and the consciousness of paternity, and the consciousness of plurality, and the consciousness of prosperity. Our Father. So you can help me share this message with people all over the earth by sowing a seed, meeting a need, boosting the post. You can do that on our website, drpulley.com. You can also do it through our Cash App, which is also there. At 7 o'clock, which is almost now, I'm getting ready to start our prayer line on my personal page, Darrell R. Pulley, and we'll be taking your prayer requests. If you're looking for a shorter version of today's message, you can find it on Twitter or Instagram, a one-minute version. If you want to tease somebody with a taste of the Daily Download, you can find it on Instagram or Twitter, which is also Dr. Pulley. You can also find us on YouTube to find previous messages that you may have missed. Well, until tomorrow morning at 6:30 a.m., remember, God is doing something wonderful in me, and God is doing something wonderful in you.